Well, hello, my darlings, and welcome back to our channel. I am so glad you are here. Can you imagine? We have gotten to day 15 of Amourfest 2019 already. I can't, but I had a thought. What better way to celebrate the end of Amourfest 2019 than giving you a preview of what is to come in our spring wedding season? I sure hope you'll stay tuned. Here are the supplies that you will need for today's project. I will be sure to place a list of the supplies below in the description box with direct links to each item for your shopping convenience. Here are the supplies that you will need for today's project. We will be using a two-part epoxy, our hot glue, our wire cutters, as well as a pair of scissors and a piece of felt. Now, let's get crafting. For the foundation of this craft, we're going to be using two dry foam bricks, which we will have to glue together. To do this, we're simply going to go in with our hot glue gun, place some hot glue on the side of one of those bricks, and then press the second brick into it, apply some pressure, and set this to dry for a few moments. Now that the two pieces of foam have dried together, we are now going to cover the bottom of our foam with a piece of black felt. The reason why we're doing this is to ensure that that dry foam does not rub off on any of your furniture or worse, your table linen. And so to do this, all we're going to do is go in with a foundation of hot glue and place our pre-measured piece of felt down in that hot glue and set it to dry for a few moments. Now that our foundation has been set into place and the back of it lined with our black felt, we are now going to prepare our mirrors. And to do this, we are going to use a two-part epoxy, of course, that I have mixed off camera in the essence of time. And we are actually going to glue two of our square mirrors together. Now, as you can see, I am placing my epoxy on the four corners of this mirror, and then just to ensure that I can continue working in this video, I am also going to go in with a foundation of hot glue, which of course is going to give me my right now adhesion while my epoxy cures over time. And all I'm going to do is simply find my placement, edge to edge, corner to corner on both of these mirrors, apply some pressure, and allow that epoxy to set before I finagle with these mirrors again. Now I'm just going to reheat this hot glue just to ensure that it is not dried all the way through, and then once again I'm going to take my last mirror, or my third mirror, and place it on top of my fourth, lining it up and applying some pressure. Now, here we have our mirrors that have been dried and set into place, and I have placed them standing up on their edges. What we are going to do now is take our fifth mirror. We are going to place some epoxy again down in that corner, and we are going to overlay that fifth mirror in the middle of our two mirrors, or two pairs of mirrors that we have epoxied together. Now, once you have placed your mirror down, found your placement, of course, you are going to apply some pressure and allow that to set before you go in on the opposite side and place your final mirror in place. Now that our mirrors have dried and have been set into place, it is now time to place them in our styrofoam. Now what I'm doing here is using my tape measure to measure my foundation, which comes in at approximately 16 inches, and then measuring my mirrors, which come in at about 13 and a half inches, and I'm looking to find the optimum, the ultimate placement where my mirrors will be perfectly centered. Once I have found that placement, it is going to be a matter of taking my mirrors, making an etching where I need them to sit, and once I have placed that etching, removing them from the foundation, getting my hot glue, placing some hot glue at those two points, and then taking my mirrors and sticking them right back in that place and pushing them down until I get them precisely where I need them embedded in that styrofoam. Once I have found my perfect placement, I'm going to hold this in place to ensure that that hot glue is going to set up and those mirrors will be able to stand tall and secure. Now here we have our piece with our mirrors embedded, and what I'm showing you here in 100% transparency, I did not place that center mirror completely centered. So as you can see, it is kicking off a little to the side, but for my purposes, I think it gives it a little bit of character. Just be sure not to make the same mistake, my darlings. And as you can see, what I just showed you there is because those middle mirrors have been placed atop the two mirrors that are to the left and to the right of it. We have that gaping hole that we need to cover. I am going to use these floral arrangements and my hot glue gun by going in and placing a few bullets of that hot glue on the side of the mirror, and then very carefully, because these flower embellishments are just, hear me when I tell you, the right size. And so as you can see, just very gingerly placing those flowers down into that glue in an effort to cover up that gap. I am going to continue that process on the tops of all of our mirrors off camera. Then what I'm going to do is one of my favorite parts, make our floral embellishment by going in with some hydrangea heads, some lilac roses, blush roses, and some orange and fuchsia roses. I am going to make this flower arrangement, of course, finish it off camera. I will clean my mirrors, remove any glue fronds there are, and then I will stage our piece and return to show you what our finished project looks like. Here you have it, my darlings, our mirrored spring fling centerpiece. Isn't this absolutely stunning? What better way to end Amourfest 2019 than getting ready for the spring season? Listen, when I look at this piece, I see glam, I see luxury, I see elegance through and through this piece. And once again, my darlings, I think I will have to say that we have nailed yet another project. This would be a gorgeous piece to punctuate your spring tablescape this year. Well, my darlings, I would just like to tell you thank you so very much to tuning in to Amourfest 2019. I am so glad that we have had this time to spend together. I look forward to the many great and beautiful things that we will be creating in 2009, and I can't wait to spend that time with you. So until our next video, my darlings, I say to you, please, 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 take care of yourselves for me. Know that I love you all. Bye now.
If you're impressed with what you see, feel free to like and subscribe.